Hey folks, this is Gabe, Security Baron, and in today's world, privacy and protection are the name of the game. So today we're gonna check out Enpass Password Manager to see what it can do for you. In today's review of Enpass Password Manager, we're gonna go over some pros and cons, its feature set, the subscription options, its customer support before finally diving into its mobile application, the Enpass app, to make sure you have all the information you need to make the right decision. If you want to see a list of our favorite password managers, Google Security Baron Best Password Managers. If you have a question about today's review, leave us a comment and I'll get back to you. Let's kick off today's review of Enpass Password Manager, looking at some pros and cons, beginning with the pros. Now, Enpass Manager, in terms of subscriptions, is just a one-time fee. You're not looking at a monthly recurring fee each month for using Enpass. Now, that probably goes to the point that it just has all of your information locally encrypted. They do not keep things on their servers. So in terms of privacy, Enpass is doing really well because everything is right there on that device. Now, when it comes to cons, you're gonna have to pay that one-time fee for each device that you'd like to have associated with your Enpass account. On top of that, you do not have the option to designate an emergency contact. So if you forget for any reason, you hit your head, you may have an issue because once you forget that master password, you will be locked out without that designated emergency contact. Now that we've gone through the pros and cons of Enpass Password Manager, let's check out that feature set. Now, the main feature for any password manager, and Enpass is no different, is that vault of passwords. Doing away with the need to remember countless passwords because you just have that one master password that allows you to access all of your different logins and different information you have out there on the web. Now, one thing to note about that is that you cannot really just import from a browser directly with Enpass. You're gonna have to get a properly formatted CSV file, and that should expedite the process of inputting your various passwords. Now, when it comes to what happens after that, you're gonna put each of those to a password strength report that they provide for you at Enpass. Now, they'll tell you this is an old password, a weak password, or a repeated password, and then you can actually use a password generator built into both the mobile and desktop app for Enpass to create new, stronger passwords, and they actually even give you the option to really change up the manner by which you set up those passwords. Now, the best part is once you've set that up and started to put in your information, it can autofill different forms for you on the internet, so you don't have to go through that process of putting in your name and phone number or something like that. Now, in terms of protection, you also have the industry standards in password cracking and encryption with Enpass Password Manager. And if you ever need to share any of your passwords, you can do so with a pre-shared security key. Now, when it comes to storage on Enpass Password Manager, it's all dependent on you. You can decide to go with iCloud or Dropbox or Google Drive, because remember, they do not keep your data in their own servers. So while it may not be the most extensive password manager that we've seen, there's more to Enpass Password Manager than initially meets the eye. Hold up, I hope you're enjoying today's review of Enpass Password Manager. If you want to get up to date on the newest in password managers, VPNs, and smart home security, subscribe to our channel, Security Baron. We're dropping new hot content weekly. All right, let's get back to the video. Now that we've gone over the pros and cons and the feature set, let's check out the subscription options for Enpass. Now, while most password managers have monthly or annual rates, Enpass is just a flat one-time fee per device. So if I want to use it on my iPhone, I'm going to pay $11.99, and there it is on my iPhone. If I want to use it on my MacBook, I'm going to pay $11.99, and that's it for my MacBook. So that's something to keep in mind. Now, it may be a little bit more expensive in the short term, we do think that overall this is a less expensive option, generally speaking. Now, one thing to note is that they do not offer family or business plans. They're very much geared towards individuals and just one device at a time, which is something to keep in mind when looking at the subscription options for Enpass Password Manager. Now I wanna talk about the customer support for Enpass Password Manager. Now, Enpass Password Manager does have an online FAQ that can help you answer your questions. You can email them and you can even give them a call between 11 and 6 IST. Now, we reached out to them on a number of occasions because we really wanted to bolster what we couldn't find on the internet. There were essentially no reviews out there related to the customer support for Enpass. And even in our experience, no one got back to us. We reached out, we got a form response thanking us for reaching out, but we did not ever get an actual answer to any of the questions that we asked. So it does seem that customer support is a major drawback for Enpass Password Manager. The final thing I want to delve into today is the Enpass mobile application. Now you can find Enpass on a host of devices, Androids, iOSs, Mac, Windows, even some version of the application exists on Linux. In the Apple app and Google Play Store, people seem to be particularly liking their experience where it has a 4.6 in each of those stores. So let's go ahead and check it out. I mean, that space where you're interfacing with everything on my iPhone 7 Plus. So here I am in the Enpass mobile application on my iPhone 7 Plus. Now you see here in the initial, well, let's call it the home page, it says all items. At the top, you have your favorites. Then below that, you have various different accounts and logins that you can use. Now, one thing I wanna break down about this first page is that you can just go ahead and search for anything by fields, titles, and passwords right there. In the all items section. In the upper left-hand corner, you see a cloud. So let's tap on that cloud. In the cloud, you have your various items. And one thing to note about Enpass is that it is one of the most impressive password managers when it comes to privacy. And you actually have to sync your various accounts in some cloud or another. So if you go into your iPhone, you may use iCloud like we did. You can also use Dropbox or Google Drive, or there's a host of options. So we'll get out of here. And if you wanted to add a new item on the opposite side, you see that plus sign, tap on that, and then you see all of these different groups. So what I like about the all items page and really just scrolling here is that there are just so many different things you can put in. Like my two that I really like are the lens prescription, because as you all know, I wear glasses. And the cloth size. So if I'm really in a bind, need to buy a suit, let's say I'm in a wedding somewhere, I can just go here and remember exactly what my sizes are, for anything I might need. Now, if I keep going up, you have your travel details, you have your license details, finance, and let's go ahead and look at these groups. So if we to go into the categories, you'll see the various logins, credit card, identity like your driver's license or passport. You have a note, and you can also put in your credit card, bank information, computer information if you have various servers that you need to use for different things, and there's the need to put in a password. All that's there. It actually is really helpful because you can put in different tags. So if you put in these tags, you'll actually be able to group things without putting them in the same group. So if you, for example, have your passport or various notes about travel that you need to remember, you could just tag all of those notes with the word passport. And then when you're searching through your password manager, everything you need related to a trip you're taking abroad can be in the same place. And that's something I find really helpful and where Enpass really shows that it has some depth to it. So let's go ahead out of here and look at audit. Now in audit, you get an analysis of the data you've saved in Enpass. So you can look at what you've had that has been found in a data breach. So you see here in my audit, it says I've been pwned when it comes to my wireless router. So the passwords from these items have been found in data breaches and must never be used. So I need to go ahead and switch out my router password. Now, if I go to the next one, it says these are all weak. So all of these different passwords for these sites are weak passwords. And you can also see which ones are identical. Now, if I wanted to fix these, I can generate a strong password right here in the auditing tab. So I go to generate password, and you'll see here that there's a password been generated. I can change the length of the words, which is pretty cool. I can make the words pronounceable or not. I can include uppercase digits. I can separate them by dollar signs or spaces or hyphens or periods. So it's pretty interesting and useful to have this level of versatility in creating your own passwords, where you can just decide if you really want to make it easier, harder to remember for yourself, you can do it all within the app. The final thing I'll note is the settings. Now, Enpass doesn't have the most features of any of the password managers that we've seen, but it does, you know, definitely have some depth to it. And you can see that in the settings in terms of syncing, creating a new vault, looking at your general settings, security, Apple Watch. You can also have it autofill various elements. So if you're filling out something online, you can go to your iPhone settings and just set it up so that Enpass will fill it out for you. I honestly think that autofill element is one of the more useful pieces of using a password manager. All right, so now we're back at the homepage, all items, and that's our look at Enpass Password Manager's mobile application. All right, we've come a long way with Enpass, but you want to know, Gabe, what are the things I would love about Enpass, or what are the things I may not love so much? And I'll tell you, when it comes to Enpass, it is really affordable. I mean, $11.99 for one device lifetime, it's pretty great. And even when it comes to privacy, I like that element of it. I mean, they don't put things into their servers. You can have everything locally encrypted just to your device, or you can decide you trust your particular cloud service of choice, be it iCloud, Dropbox, Google Drive. You get the idea. There are a host of different cloud services that do work with Enpass. Now, things I'm not loving so much about Enpass is the fact that I cannot designate an emergency contact. You know, I'm going snowboarding this weekend and I want to make sure if I hit my head, I can get back into my device. Well, there's no way to do that. There is no designating of that emergency contact like mom or girlfriend. That's just not going to happen. And when it comes to customer support, well, doesn't really seem to be the move with Enpass. We had some difficulties getting in touch with them. And so if customer support is something you're looking for, you may want to look somewhere else. But overall, for $11.99 for each device, I think it's a solid choice for your password manager. So that concludes our review of Enpass Password Manager. If you appreciate today's video, give us a like and hit that subscribe button. As always, this is Gabe with Security Baron. Be secure.